Did You Know video series from the National Cancer Institute, Thyroid Cancer. Did you know that new diagnoses of thyroid cancer have been on the rise in recent decades? Some, although not all of this increase, can be explained by improved detection methods. The thyroid is a gland at the base of your throat. Thyroid hormones control your heart rate, body temperature, the amount of calcium in the blood, and your metabolism, or how quickly food is changed into energy. Thyroid cancer is the eighth most common cancer in the United States, representing almost 4% of all new cancer cases. Thyroid cancer is more common in women than in men. The highest rates are found in whites, followed closely by Asian and Pacific Islanders, then by Hispanics, American Indians and Alaska Natives, and blacks. The overall 5-year relative survival rate for thyroid cancer is 98%. This means that out of every 100 people diagnosed, 98 will still be alive 5 years after diagnosis. Thyroid cancer survival rates are highest among those diagnosed with localized or regional stage disease. Almost 7 out of 10 patients are diagnosed before their cancer has spread outside of the thyroid. Because survival statistics are based on large groups of people, they cannot be used to predict exactly what will happen to an individual patient. Thyroid cancer is typically slow-growing, highly treatable, and usually curable. Risk factors for thyroid cancer include being a woman, Asian, 25 to 65 years of age, and having a family history of thyroid disease, an enlarged thyroid, or thyroid cancer. Other factors that increase risk for thyroid cancer are exposure to medical radiation to the head and neck as a child, exposure to radiation released from an atomic bomb or a nuclear power plant accident, such as Chernobyl. From the mid-1940s through the early 1960s, the U.S. government conducted atomic bomb tests in Nevada, New Mexico, and the Pacific. The radioactive substances released from these bombs, or fallout, were carried thousands of miles away by wind. One of these radioactive substances is iodine-131, or I-131. I-131 would collect on pastures and on grass, where grazing cows and goats would eat. Sometimes, the milk would contain I-131. Children who drank milk during that time could be at a higher risk for thyroid cancer. I-131 collects in the thyroid gland. Although the potential of developing thyroid cancer from exposure to I-131 from nuclear weapons testing is small, it is important that Americans who grew up during the atomic bomb testing between 1945 and 1963 are aware of the risks. For more information on thyroid cancer, go to cancer.gov or call 1-800-4-CANCER. For more cancer statistics, go to seer.cancer.gov.